Scientists explore low-dose radiation as coronavirus treatment. Several countries have launched medical trials to test the safety and efficacy of low doses of radiation on severely ill coronavirus patients. The results from a study on 5 severely ill coronavirus patients in Atlanta's Emory University Hospital were reportedly positive. The 5 patients whose median age was 90 had severe pneumonia and required supplemental oxygen. Described as having health that was visibly deteriorating, each patient was given just one low dose of radiation to both lungs, around 50 times less than needed for the treatment of cancer. According to Jim Konka, a scientist and guest opinion contributor to the Tri-City Herald newspaper and Forbes magazine, the patients were in and out of the hospital's radiotherapy department in 10 to 15 minutes. 4 of the 5 patients had rapidly improved within 24 hours, exhibiting better oxygenation and acting more alert, talkative, and more awake. After 12 days and no adverse effects such as acute or gastrointestinal toxicities, they were allowed to leave the hospital. Low-dose radiation attempts to combat the often deadly cytokine release syndrome or cytokine storm, which refers to the immune system's uncontrolled systematic inflammatory response to the novel coronavirus. The immune system released large amounts of pro-inflammatory cytokines, triggering acute respiratory distress syndrome and ultimately killing patients. Clinical trials exploring the use of low-dose radiation seek to prove that the treatment is safe for elderly patients, considering that COVID-19 fatality rates are worse for the elderly. What scientists are after is the radiation's anti-inflammatory effects, and they believe its use on COVID-19 would be convenient because most hospitals already have the equipment and are trained to use radiation on cancer patients. Konka, who is part of the American Nuclear Society and American Chemical Society, estimates that tens of thousands of lives could have been saved if hospitals used low-dose radiation on coronavirus patients at the beginning of the pandemic. It's possible that fear of low doses of radiation has played a part in the public's reluctance to take part in radiation treatments, even for cancer. However, a study published on June 8 on the preprint server medrxiv.org found that low-dose whole-lung radiation is safe, shows early promise of efficacy, and warrants further study in larger prospective trials. A similar May study in the Nature Public Health Emergency Collection also considered it worth investigating in the clinical setting.